In the pitch-black depths of the ocean, an extraordinary feature illuminates the darkness. Bioluminescence, the ability of living organisms to produce their own light, transforms the deep sea into a mesmerizing spectacle of living lanterns. This remarkable adaptation isn't just a captivating light show. It's a vital survival strategy that has shaped life in the abyss for millions of years. At its core, bioluminescence is a chemical reaction occurring within an organism's body. This process involves a light-emitting molecule called luciferin reacting with an enzyme known as luciferase. When these two components combine in the presence of oxygen, energy is released in the form of light. It's a bit like a microscopic fireworks display happening inside the creature's body. What makes bioluminescence truly remarkable is its prevalence in the deep sea. Studies have shown that a staggering 75% to 90% of marine organisms at these depths possess this ability. From tiny plankton to large squid, the ocean depths are alive with living light. The colors of bioluminescence in the deep sea are predominantly blue and green. This isn't a random choice, but a result of evolution fine-tuning the process. Blue and green light waves travel the farthest through water, making them the most visible colors in the deep sea. It's nature's way of ensuring that when these creatures light up, they're seen by those they intend to communicate with. In the challenging environment of the deep sea, bioluminescence serves multiple crucial purposes. Let's dive into the various ways deep-sea creatures use their living lights to survive and thrive in the darkness. One of the most fascinating uses of bioluminescence is as a tool for hunting. Some deep-sea predators have evolved to use their light-producing abilities as a lure, attracting unsuspecting prey right into their waiting jaws. The poster child for this strategy is the infamous anglerfish. A creature with a disproportionately large head, needle-sharp teeth, and a long fishing rod-like appendage protruding from its forehead. At the end of this fishing rod dangles a bioluminescent lure, powered by symbiotic bacteria living within. This glowing orb acts as a beacon in the darkness, drawing in curious prey who mistake it for a potential meal. As the prey approaches, the anglerfish strikes, swallowing its victim whole. But the anglerfish isn't alone in using this clever trick. The stoplight loose jaw, a type of dragonfish, takes this strategy to another level. It possesses a unique ability to produce red light, a color most deep-sea creatures can't see. This gives the stoplight loose jaw a significant advantage, allowing it to illuminate and hunt its prey without being detected. While some creatures use bioluminescence to hunt, others employ it as a means of defense. In the deep sea, a well-timed flash of light can mean the difference between life and death. Consider the vampire squid, a creature that looks far more fearsome than it actually is. When threatened, this cephalopod can eject a cloud of bioluminescent mucus into the water. This glowing cloud serves multiple purposes. It disorients and confuses predators, giving the vampire squid a chance to escape. Moreover, the lingering cloud of light may attract larger predators, potentially turning the tables on the original attacker. Some species of shrimp have developed an even more dramatic defensive tactic.
Hey, explorers! Ready to dive deeper into the unknown? We've got exclusive insights waiting for you. Subscribe to our newsletter now. Link in the description. Stay ahead of the tide and never miss a discovery. Now, enjoy the rest of the video.
When in danger, they can expel a burst of bioluminescent liquid, essentially spitting light at their attackers. This sudden flash can startle predators, buying the shrimp precious seconds to make their escape. In a world where any silhouette against the faint light from above can attract unwanted attention, some deep-sea creatures have evolved a clever form of camouflage using bioluminescence. This technique, known as counter-illumination, is particularly common among midwater fish like lanternfish. Lanternfish have rows of light-producing photophores along their undersides. These organs emit a soft glow that matches the faint sunlight filtering down from above. By adjusting the intensity of this light, the fish can effectively erase their silhouette, blending seamlessly with the surrounding water. To a predator looking up from below, the lanternfish becomes virtually invisible. This form of active camouflage is a testament to the ingenuity of evolution. It's a reminder that, in the deep sea, survival often depends on the ability to control light, whether by producing it or by using it to disappear. In the vast, dark expanse of the deep ocean, finding a mate can be a daunting task. Here too, bioluminescence plays a crucial role, serving as a beacon for potential partners. Many deep-sea creatures use specific patterns of light to identify members of their own species. The lanternfish, for instance, has a unique arrangement of photophores that acts like a species-specific barcode. When looking for a mate, they can recognize these patterns, ensuring they don't waste energy pursuing the wrong species. Some organisms take this a step further, using elaborate light displays as part of their courtship rituals. The ostracod, a tiny crustacean, is particularly famous for this. Males of certain ostracod species release clouds of bioluminescent chemicals into the water, creating a mesmerizing display of blue light. Females are attracted to these underwater fireworks, leading to successful mating. Even in the deepest parts of the ocean, where life seems impossibly harsh, bioluminescence ensures that the flame of romance continues to burn bright. Now that we've explored the why of bioluminescence, let's delve into the how. The ability to produce light is a complex biological process that has evolved independently multiple times in different species. This convergent evolution underscores just how valuable bioluminescence is as a survival strategy in the deep sea. At the heart of bioluminescence are two key components, a molecule called luciferin and an enzyme named luciferase. Luciferin is the light-emitting compound, while luciferase acts as a catalyst for the reaction. When luciferin is oxidized, combined with oxygen, in the presence of luciferase, the result is the production of light. What's fascinating is that there isn't just one type of luciferin. Different groups of organisms have evolved their own versions of this molecule. For instance, the luciferin found in jellyfish is different from that in fireflies or deep-sea fish. This diversity in luciferins is one reason why bioluminescence can produce different colors in different species. The actual production of light occurs in specialized structures called photophores, or light organs. These can range from simple clusters of light-producing cells to complex organs complete with lenses, reflectors, and color filters. In many fish, photophores are arranged in specific patterns along the body. These patterns can be used for species recognition or to break up the fish's silhouette through counter-illumination. Some creatures, like the anglerfish, have a single large light organ used as a lure. The complexity of these light organs is truly remarkable. Some have reflective layers to direct the light outward, while others have lens-like structures to focus the light. Some even have shutters or pigment layers that can be used to control when and how much light is emitted. While many deep-sea creatures produce their own light through internal chemical reactions, some have developed a different strategy. They host bioluminescent bacteria in their light organs. The relationship between these creatures and their light-producing tenants is a classic example of symbiosis. The host provides a safe, nutrient-rich environment for the bacteria, and in return, the bacteria provide light. This arrangement is seen in various species, including some anglerfish and squid. One of the most famous examples of this symbiotic relationship is the Hawaiian bobtail squid. This small cephalopod houses bioluminescent bacteria in a special light organ. The squid can control the amount of light produced by regulating the population of bacteria, essentially using them as a living dimmer switch. The prevalence of bioluminescence in the deep sea is a proof to its evolutionary success. But why did this trait become so common in these dark depths? To understand this, we need to consider the unique challenges of life in the deep sea and how bioluminescence helps organisms overcome them. The deep sea is an environment defined by darkness. Below 1,000 meters, sunlight is all but absent, creating a world where visual communication and navigation are severely limited. In this environment, any ability to produce light provides a significant advantage. Bioluminescence allows organisms to create their own light source, effectively expanding their ability to interact with their environment. Whether it's used for finding food, avoiding predators, or locating mates, the ability to control light emission in a dark world is invaluable. Moreover, the deep sea is vast and sparsely populated. The ability to produce light allows organisms to communicate over longer distances, increasing their chances of finding food or mates in this expansive environment. One might wonder why organisms would evolve to produce their own light in an environment where energy is scarce. Surprisingly, bioluminescence is an incredibly efficient process. The chemical reaction that produces light generates very little heat, meaning almost all the energy is converted into light. This efficiency is crucial in the deep sea, where food can be scarce and every bit of energy counts. The ability to produce light without wasting energy as heat makes bioluminescence an attractive option for deep sea creatures. As we continue to explore the depths of our oceans, we're sure to uncover even more surprises. The deep sea remains one of the least explored frontiers on our planet, and each dive brings new discoveries. Who knows what other luminous wonders await us in the abyssal depths? And if you want to dive deeper into the mysteries of the ocean, make sure you're subscribed to this channel. And don't forget to tap the bell icon to receive notifications whenever we upload new content.